Hello, I'm Rashad Burgess, the chief of the capacity building branch within the Division of HIV and AIDS Prevention at the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. I am very excited to speak to you about our newly released funding opportunity announcement, Capacity Building Assistance for High Impact HIV Prevention, PS14-1403. This announcement is listed on CDC's webpage. The purpose of this funding opportunity is to strengthen the capacity of the HIV prevention workforce to optimally plan, implement, and sustain high-impact prevention activities and strategies within health departments, community-based organizations, and healthcare organizations to reduce HIV-related morbidity, mortality, and disparities across the United States and its territories. In fiscal year 2012, CDC revised its HIV Prevention by Health Departments program to better match HIV prevention funding to the geographic burden of HIV infection and prioritize activities that will have the greatest impact on the epidemic. In fiscal year 2014, CDC will institute Community High Impact HIV Prevention, known as CHIP, a new initiative to ship programmatic efforts of capacity building and community-based organizations to further maximize HIV prevention impact. This funding opportunity will support the single flagship capacity building assistance program that fully reflects CDC's new direction. Awardees of this program will constitute a national capacity building assistance provider network. Available funding is categorized by the primary organizational consumers of capacity building services. Category A, health departments. Category B, community-based organizations. And category C, healthcare organizations. In addition, a fourth category, category D, CBER Provider Network Resource Center, will provide overarching network coordination and support for awardees funded under categories A, B, and C. Awardees will implement all program requirements and deliver free, high-quality capacity building assistance services, including information dissemination, training for skills development, and technical assistance for health departments, community-based organizations, and healthcare organizations to plan, implement, and sustain high-impact prevention activities. This table summarizes the scope of work under PS14-1403. Applicants for Category A, B, and C must limit the focus of their CBER program to three of the components listed for each category. Applicants for Category D must address all listed components. Based on availability of funds and desired programmatic coverage, there may be up to 25 awards. The average award is an estimated $1.25 million, with a minimum of $500,000 and a maximum of $3 million, depending on the funding category. Applicants may apply for no more than two categories under this funding opportunity announcement. Please be aware that separate applications are required for each category. To apply for this funding opportunity, please visit grants.gov. This funding opportunity, PS14-1403, fully reflects CDC's new direction for providing high-quality capacity-building assistance to support CDC's high-impact HIV prevention and achieve the goals of the national HIV/AIDS strategy. I encourage you to regularly visit the CDC program webpage for up-to-date information regarding pre-application technical assistance events, frequently asked questions, and other resources. I'm Rashad Burgess. Please let us know if you have any questions by reaching us at hipta@cdc.gov. That's hipta@cdc.gov. Thank you for your interest in this funding opportunity.